Hey, my name is Ben. I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. In today's video, we're going to do this vignette effect. This is a post effect that is happening. You can see it here on this bottom screen. The vignette can be changed into different colors. It has a little bit of inversion on some of the colors here. You can control the radius and the amount of feathering happening at the edges. This is also should be suitable to any camera ratio. So so if you guys like what you see, please subscribe and support my channel. Let's jump right into it. Okay, so the setup we have for this effect is quite simple. What we have is a source splitting to start render texture and then splitting back to the destination texture. We're doing everything in pass number 5, as you can see right here. All we're doing is splitting the main text back onto the screen. First thing we should do is create a circle because we're going to create a vignette. So I think we want to start with a circle using the UVs. So let's do a float to new UVs. We'll take the i.uv. And as always, we have (x(-1) to move everything into the center. Next, what we want to do is do a float. We'll call it circle to make it very clear. And we do a length on the new UV. Just by doing that, we can return this. Let's return a fixed 4. We'll return the circle value and we'll put a 1 in the alpha. Cool. So we have our circle happening here. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is have a radius and a step function to determine where we want to show and hide our vignette. So let's go ahead and go back to our post effects controller. Here I'll create a radius. It'll be a float value. Radius. And we'll go ahead and create in our post effects material, I will also create a radius value. So we'll do a set float. I'll call it underscore radius. And we'll send in our radius. So in our shader here, we'll have a float radius. Now we can create our step function. We'll set our radius to 1 for now. So our step function will look like this. It will be a float step is equal to, let's do a step with the radius first against our circle value. Let's go ahead and display that. I probably cannot call this step. We'll call this mask. Yeah. So now we have our radius that can show our vignette value. In order for us to invert this, let's go ahead and do a 1- on the mask. And now we have our color. What we're going to do is display our color multiplied by our mask. Our color will be RGB. Cool. Now we have a very simple vignette. Of course, there's no like shading. There's no softness to it, but this is a very basic hard-edged vignette. All right, so the next thing we want to do is we probably need a little bit of feathering here. So let's go ahead and add that. We'll call it feather. Feather, yeah. And I'll go ahead and, oops. I'll create underscore feather here. And then we'll use our feather effect here. Let's save this off. Here we'll have float radius, float feather. And instead of step, we're going to do smooth step. And are going to take Radius is fine at the beginning. We can do radius plus feather. And then we're going to do it offset by, so we're going to step it by the circle value. So here now we have a feather amount. So we can have our vignette go in like this, and we can create a little bit of a feathering effect. Cool. So one very good thing to have is now that we have this all set up, we could have an inverted mask. So let's do a float invert mask is equal to mask 1 minus mask. If we use our invert mask, we'll have an inverted vignette, right? So this is our inverted vignette. And the reason why we want to ever do this is if we ever want to do, you know, other types of effects with our inverted mask. So something we can do is we can tint our vignette. So it'll look something like this. Let's go ahead and do a public color. We'll call it tint color. And here we'll do a set color. Set the tint color, and here I'll call it tint color. In our shader, we'll have a float 4 with the tint color. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the, so we have our original color. Let's do 2. We'll call it, to make things really clear, we'll do float 4 display color is equal to cull times cull.rgb times mask. And because it's RGB, I think I'm just going to do a float 3 here. Then we'll call our vignetted color. This is going to be the edge where it's darkened. Vignetted color. It'll be color times inverted mask times a tint color. And then our vignette color will look like this. Our color is black, so let's go ahead and give it maybe a reddish hue or maybe an orangey hue. Right, and our display color looks like this. So in order for us to make these two work together, we simply add them. Right. And now we have a tinted vignette that we can control the radius, we control our feathering amount, and we can of course retint it how we like. Right, it doesn't have to always be black, it can be a slight orangey feel. It really depends on the effect you're looking to achieve. One other effect that you could do, and in some games I've seen this, is not to use a tint color, but to do an inverted color. So it would look, to do that, all we have to do is 1 minus the color.rgb and make sure we bracket it off. Right, so now we have an inverted color on our edges here. So we can have a huge feathering effect. So yeah. And then when we move our camera around, we have our vignetted, our inverted vignette color. You can darken it, you can multiply this by a tint color to create a really crazy effect. Tint color. Right, so now it has a bit of inversion as well as yeah. So go ahead, have fun with this one, and that's it for this particular video. I hope you guys learned something. If you guys like what you see, please subscribe and support my channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.